Alright, welcome back to No Man's Sky. I've just saved my game. You remember where we are? We fixed our... Let me jump in the building here. Boy, this toxicity falls quickly. We just repaired the ship, if you recall. The ship is all ready to go. I could use some iron to power up the pulse engine, but I've got some iron over here, so that's not really a problem. What is a problem is that we're low on platinum and shields. My ship is 9 minutes away, and I am not sure if I try to run to my ship. You see, the toxicity is really doing a number on me. So I am not sure that I could make it to my ship with the shields I have and apparently no place to hide. The thing I've noticed about this map, I mean, besides all the happy little trees, is that there's no place to hide. There's no buildings. There's no caves. I don't know where I could hide. Well, is this a cave? Wait a second. I wanted to get those. I got a rock. I wanted to get the... Alright, this is not really a cave. No, it's just kind of a hole. Alright. So... Man. I wish there was just some place for me to rest and get out of the toxic weather. But there isn't. So what we're going to have to do... If you remember when we first started this little trek, I was all excited about my good starting location. I better get back to the... where am I going? Whoa, what's that? Luca Nazar, some kind. I better get back there. All right. If you remember my starting location, I had a beacon, which will call my ship to me. Now there are some things at the crash site that I want to get. The Atlas interface, there's going to be more technology to get, so I can call my ship to me where we started and then hopefully fly back to what's that plaque no I oh there's where I was that's where I started hopefully I'll call my ship to me and then I will fly back to where the ship was. Normally on survival mode, people complain they can't really fly their ship around because there's not enough plutonium. But the one thing I see on this planet seems to be copious amounts of plutonium. That's where I want to go, right up there, on the top of the hill. There's a plutonium near everywhere around here, and I've got a lot of it. Although I do need it for life support, since there's no, well, very little thamium. So basically, I'm just going to work my way back to my original starting point. Pulse jet. A little thamium. I'll work my way back to my original starting point. Oh, it's getting to be nighttime. You see, it's getting a little darker. And then I'll call my ship to me. What do we have here? Iridium? Looks like iridium. It's not giving me a reading. Yeah. I'm going to hollow out a hole. Remember this trick? Well, we did this with the iridium. So that'll help me out a bit. Iridium is more of a late game item. We don't really need it right now. But, so that's the plan. We'll get the ship, we'll call the ship to us. And then go back to where the ship came from and get the things that I was supposed to get. There's no way for me to get all the way to the ship from here. Well, I mean, I'd never say never, but it's hard to try. In buildings, your toxic protection increases a lot faster than it does in these rocks. You can see it tick up and up and up. The slowest tick, if you're in a cave, that's probably the worst spot. I'd be waiting here 15-20 minutes for this to happen. But inside this iridium, I guess it's a little better than being in a cave. So we'll just sit here, take a breath, think about what we want to do, try to get up to the base. I don't think we're going to be able to get into space. I don't think we're going to leave the planet. There's still plenty on the planet to examine, to look at. There's lots of different buildings. Hopefully we'll get more supplies, whatever that might be. Get our exosuit a little bigger. All right, let's go. Is there anything around here that would be good? Ooh. Alright, so there's some plutonium. Ooh. Alright. I'm kind of going the wrong way, but. I should really be scanning these animals. Well, I've gotten a lot of the animals that are around here. One of the things you do is you scan the animals, as you've seen me scan a few of them already. You want to get, well, I don't know if I'd say you want to, but you can get all the animals on a planet, and then you'll get a bonus. Just some credits. And credits are not really ever a problem. I mean, are you going to buy something? Ooh, 50% already. I didn't know it was going that fast. But, you know, they give you money for doing things, but money is not really that important when you're fighting for your survival. I'm gonna have to use a shield soon. I picked up a little bit more platinum. Platinum is the little blue plants, and platinum is used in shield production. I like these happy trees because you can shoot them as you go along. Less than a minute, should be able to make it fine. Oh, I should have got that iron. I need more iron. If you look right above my gun, that's a little thamium plant. Always need thamium. always. You can use your jetpack to fly up a flat surface. I think this is more of a flat surface here. It won't help you if you're over to the right more. It was kind of a S-shaped wall, and the jetpack really wouldn't help with that. But a flat surface, it does much better. All right, so we're back here. You might remember we started, I think, right over there in front of that building. Use another rock. And the building right in front of us was a... what was the name of it? Can't remember what those buildings are called. It's the one with the big antenna on top. We will find out in a second. Watch my toxic protection. It'll shoot up really a lot faster now in the building. We've got to go up the green bar. This is the... I've already used this. It won't tell me what it was. Anyway, it's a signal. All right, here we go. Let's save our game. I always want to save games. And come over here to the thing that's going to save us. Call the starship. There it is. There's our tiny little starship. Even better, when you land next to one of these things, you don't have to call it, but if you land, when you're flying around and you land next to one of them, I get a takeoff for free. Normally, to take off, it costs 200. If you look at the launch thruster, it costs 200 platinum or plutonium to fill. But since I'm at one of those things, I don't have to worry about it. I get a takeoff for free. All right. So now we'll send some of these things. We're in our ship now, finally. So let's charge up while we recover from the elements. Some of these things I'm looking to sell. The dagger, the convergence cube, this iridium. I can sell that for a little bit of money. All right, now what do I have? Oh, I could use... I don't know what I could use. I don't really need anything. Could use a little carbon and iron, but that's about it. Before we take off, let's get a little bit more. Again, I mean, these things are everywhere. You've seen me almost nonstop doing plants and rocks to get the carbon and iron. But like I said before, it'll soon I won't need to do that very much. All right, there doesn't appear to be any more animals around here. So let's do it. Oh. All right, let's take off. Our first flight in our new repaired starship. There you go, journey milestone. Starship launch. Although it did technically launch before anybody was even in it. It launched, now I've got to find where I crashed. Well, I should have. Alright, well, heck. Alright. So now, we're just going to scan the planet. Well, not particularly scan it, but we're going to fly around looking for some place to land, something of interest. That's not really of interest, but we're going to do it anyway. Normally, we wouldn't land in such a location, but we've got lots of plutonium. Again, plutonium is usually the limiting factor on where you want to land. You don't want to land somewhere where you can't take off again. I mean, that. Ooh, it's getting dark. As it gets dark, it'll be harder and harder to be able to see things. In each of these buildings, usually there's something of value. And this one, a multi-tool technology. The beam intensifier Theta. Mining beam laser is strengthened to speed up terrain destruction. So if I can get some copper and some more iridium, I could use that. But at the start of the game, you're basically just going to trade in your the things you have. That's a unusual animal. Let's get out there. At the start of the game, you're usually going to trade in the things you have. So you don't want to upgrade them too much. What is that thing? Oh, look at that. That's an unusually headed animal. Blockhead. Oh, I've already got him. I already got him. And I think I got her. Yeah. I believe I got one of those when I was traveling with a little baby. But that is not even a head. What are those things? Alright. I mean, I know you're on a foreign, you know, a different planet, and things might look different, but that's just crazy. Now this is a hard rock to destroy. It's going to take me a long time to get through this rock, but any the things that give you more goodies, like I'm going to get a lot more iron out of this than I would a smaller rock, an easier to destroy rock. So this will give me a lot of iron. Unfortunately, the longer you sit here and shoot at it, greater chance of a sentinel coming and, well, ruining your day. Plus, it's really taking a toll on my toxic. Ooh, look at that. 140 iron. That's crazy. That's a lot. I gotta look for more of those rocks. They take a long time to get out, but definitely worth it. Oh, so you can hear the sentinels as they go by. Alright. I wanted to get that iron because I want to put some in the ship because I want to have enough iron to keep the pulse engine going at all times. All right. There's my ship. It's more iridium. See, normally in the normal game, you can use your scanner quite frequently. In survival mode, your scanner takes a lot longer to recharge. Like if you look in the bottom, night crystals, not useful. In the bottom right is my scanner. And you see it's going to take a long time to recharge. And the scanner did not pick up any platinum or any plutonium. No thamium. It didn't pick up anything. It's telling me there's just a bunch of carbon and iron. Alright. Oh, over there. My scanner does not work very far distances. Usually, especially on this planet, there is a lot of plutonium. And usually, if you walk around some, you'll find it. Even though I've been on planets where there wasn't much plutonium, but if you walked around, you'd find plenty. I mean, the game isn't trying to trap you or trick you. you know. All right, night crystals. Night crystals are just for money. They've never been used to create anything. Still low on famium. I do have technology I could install to help me. User is able to run for extended periods. This is not helpful in this game because I don't want to run at all. It takes too much of your life support to run. So unless you're about to die, running is not advised. All right. Send over some more of that plutonium. I want to keep plutonium and carbon. You remember that's for life support. Thamium is also for life support. Shields for hazard protection. Iron and platinum. The only thing I'm going to carry with me is things that can save my life and protect me. Everything else I'll send to my ship. And that hopefully I'll be able to sell once I find a place to sell it. That's basically why we're still on the planet. I want to find some... Oh, I thought that was a bird or something. I want to find places to sell the things I've gotten. I can sell some stuff. Get some money. Free up some slots. A lot of people, when they played the game, they complained about the number of slots in your inventory, how many things you can carry. Let's see what this journey milestone is. Toxic protection. Ambulatory. I'm walking a lot. Now, people complained about how much stuff you could carry, and it is a problem that you can't carry everything you'd want to carry. But I think that's more the game's fault for giving you so much stuff. I mean, you want to carry everything, but really, I don't think the game should be giving you nearly as much as it does. I mean, why did I need those night crystals? But you don't want to leave it behind. The game gives you free money. Why would you just give it up? So I can see where people are unhappy they don't have more slots, but you really don't need it. Here's that platinum I was talking about. Get back. You always gotta watch your toxicity level. That's gonna. Oh, I saw more. Somewhere plutonium up there. But I couldn't get it. Now look at the screen. The screen is going to start getting a little wavy. Hopefully I'll remember where I was. Ooh, zinc. Why is that lit up like that? This little ZN here. Oh, I hit my scanner. I must have hit my scanner by accident. The scanner is on the same joystick. The joystick is for walking, and the scanner is pressing down on it. L3. So sometimes I hit the scanner by accident. There it is. But most things will change color if they're important. You see it's kind of shiny and... But basically, just going to stock up on minerals. I don't want you to get the idea that these videos are just showing me stocking up on minerals. But at the beginning of the game, you don't have anything. So you really do just kind of need to get the basics. Here's the stuff. You need to get the basics. And plenty of it, you know, before you go out and do your thing. I thought I saw a bigger one. Maybe that one's it. Yeah, I think that's what I saw. I think I was shooting this one. Yep. So, you know, the whole game is not going to be me shooting rocks and trees. Alright, but we've got our ship right there. The reason I don't go into the ship in buildings is where you get your... You see the green bar is just shooting straight up. The buildings give you the best, the quickest rejuvenation. The ship is slower. Caves are the slowest. So when I have a building nearby, I'm always going to go to a building. Alright, so could use some more carbon. Thamium I'm not going to be able to find. Doing great on plutonium. I got 392 in the ship and 250 on me. So I need some iron and carbon. I said I didn't need iron and carbon. I didn't need to sit here and farm the entire game, but I want to get 500 iron here for the ship, 500 plutonium here for the ship. All right. I want to get 500 plutonium, 500 iron, 250 plutonium, 250 carbon, probably 250 iron. And then I'll have enough to make sure that no matter where I am, I'm going to be safe. I mean, that's the biggest thing, stay alive. Where's those? I'm looking for those flat rocks. The ones that took forever to... There it is. Remember, yeah, because it... You know, the thing is, you can go anywhere and do anything if you have enough materials to keep you safe. You don't always have to worry about being next to a building, being next to your ship, finding some place to hide. But the problem is at the beginning of the game you don't start with anything, so, and everything's trying to kill you. So of course your main focus is on... Look at all that iron. Your main focus is going to be on things that will save your life. Now, if you remember the last time you saw me doing all this, it was to repair my ship. This time, it's birds. Scanning the birds. Remember, scanning animals. Bold temperaments. Bold birds. That's, interesting. Oops. Oh. Now there you go. Alright, let's get back in the run. Sometimes I run by accident. Remember, running takes away your life support. Only run when you're about to die. Whoa. Alright, so my ship, I got iron and 500 iron, 500 plutonium. Alright, so I need about 185 iron, and we would be good to go. Alright, so that's what we're going to be doing. I guess we'll pause here in the building. Next video, we'll fill up on iron and carbon. And we'll go look for a building with an alien in it. This is a Corvax system, so you'll get introduced to the Corvax people. I guess they're people. They're something. I don't know what you call people. We'll meet the Corvax and sell some of our goodies. Hopefully we'll find a place to do that. This planet doesn't seem to have a lot of that going on, but hopefully we'll run into somebody. If you've liked this video and you want to see more of the spear in action, watching with more videos, share, and subscribe. You'll get more of these notices to your inbox that I've uploaded a new video. And I'll see you next time from Abu Dhabi, ISIS Zuget. Thanks for watching.